Good morning. Good morning, my dear brethren in the Lord. Good morning. It's been a while since we met like this, and I thank God for this great opportunity that I have the chance to meet with you again this morning. I have a very short message for you this morning, and I pray that this will make a change in someone's life. Whatever that you're going through, whatever the circumstance may be, I pray this morning that the Holy Spirit will speak to me and will speak to you as well. You know what? One thing I've realized about modern day Christians, the Holy Spirit was just speaking to me when I wake up this morning. We worry about what people say too much. We do. We worry about what people think of us too much. And if you do that, you cannot please God, my brother, my sister. This morning, I'm here to tell you to live your life to please Christ only. The life that you're living, be very aware and be very sure there is only one person that you're going to account to one day, which is Jesus Christ. That one person that you're going to stand before, who is going to be the judge of your life, is Christ and Christ only. So whatever journey that you're taking, whatever thing that you're doing, your thoughts, your ways, everything, make sure that it pleases Christ only and nobody else. Forget about what people think of you. Forget about people's assumptions of you. But what does Christ think of you? Sister, does your thoughts glorify Christ? At the end of the day, your behavior, does it bring people to Christ? Your appearance, does it bring people to Christ? This morning, I'm here to tell you to please Christ and please Christ only. Let your life please Christ and please Christ only and nobody else. People will say whatever they want to say. No matter what you would do, people will say it. Oh, this sister, you know, she's too slow. She needs to be fast a little bit. Oh, she's too quiet. She needs to talk a little bit. Oh, she talked too much. She needs to be quiet a little bit. Oh, she's full of herself. You see the way she talks? You see the way she walks? You see the way she do this? You see the way he does this? Please, does it glorify God? That's the number one question. Does it glorify God, whatever you're doing? The way you talk, if you talk too much. In your talk, is Christ presented? Maybe you're quiet. In your quietness, is Christ presented at that time? Maybe you walk too fast. In your walking too fast, what are you thinking of why you're walking so fast? Maybe you walk too slow. While you're walking too slow, what are you thinking of? Is Christ in that thought? Is Christ in that walk? Is Christ in that appearance? Is Christ in that behavior? Then that's what matters. Many a times we live to please people. Stop pleasing men and please God. My dear brother, stop pleasing men and please God. Maybe in your lifetime, my dear, you used to be a praise and worship leader. You used to be a prayer warrior. You used to be a preacher. You used to do so many things for Christ. But because of what somebody said, you have stopped. This tongue have realized that it's dangerous more than anything. Because somebody said that you're doing too much, you have stopped the things, the very things that you love to do for Christ. Because of one thing that somebody said, it has brought you so low that you're no longer able to get up on your feet and pray like you used to be. Because of that one word that somebody said about you and you heard, sister, you're not able to get up on that stage and praise and sing and glorify the name of God. You're not able to do those things anymore. But let me tell you something. Little did you know that those things that you were doing was your protection. Little did you know that those messages that you were sending out, those praise and worship that you're doing, that talk, that bubbly personality of yours, always love for people to come to church. Little did you know that. But don't let nobody put you down this morning. My brother, my sister, maybe because of what someone said, you have fallen short. This morning, I am here to encourage you that pick up from where you fall short. Get up on your feet and start doing the very things that you love to do in the house of God. Get up on your toes, your bubbly personalities. When you go to church, you used to say, hello, how are you doing? Greet people. Do you know who is encouraged to come to church because of that personality of yours? Because you're so talkative. Do you know somebody that admires that about you? And they love to come to you. They love to share their personal life with you because they know that you'll be out loud, you'll be outspoken to encourage them in whatever you're going through. They know that you will support them in prayer. They know that you use your bubbly personality to lift them up. My brother, my sister, it's not too late. Maybe you have fallen short. Maybe you have stopped doing the very things that you used to do in the house of God that encouraged people. You know, please remember where you fell short this morning. Remember where you fell short this morning, my brother, my sister. I am here to encourage you. Don't let nobody put you down. Don't let the words of people put you down. Be strong and be courageous in everything that you do. Our own Master Jesus Christ that we are following, people spoke against him. People lied against him. People said all kind of lies against him, things that were not true. But he knew the reason why he was on earth. He knew that he was here for one purpose and one purpose only, to die on the cross so that you and I may be liberated. My dear brother, my dear sister, God have called each and every one of us. We are all unique personalities, and God used our uniqueness to glorify himself in his way. So however God made you, wherever God have put you in you, people are going to talk about you. People are going to stab you in the back. People are going to lie against you. Some people will like your personality. Some people will hate your personality. But so far as what you're doing pleases God, that is the most important thing. So far as what you're doing, the talk, the walk, the move, the attitude, the praises, the worship, the singing, the evangelism, whatever that you're doing, the preaching, the teaching, my brother, my sister, so far as it glorifies God, that is the most important thing. I'm here to encourage you this morning. Get up and start walking. Don't fall short. Remember where you fell short. Get up this morning. Get up, get up. Wherever you are, whoever that have put you down, whoever that have brought you down, this morning, I am here. The Holy Spirit is speaking to you that, my brother, my sister, get up and walk. Pick up your mat once again and walk. Ask God that, God, forgive me that I did not listen to you, but rather I listened to what men thought of me and I stopped doing your work. God, I have picked up my mat once again. Once again, Jesus Christ, use me like you've never used me before. Use me as a vessel to glorify your name. Father, Lord Jesus, I want you to mute this ear to the saying of men, whatever negativity that will come to my life to make me fall short in your work, in your word, in everything. I rebuke it in the name of Jesus Christ. Pray this prayer with me, my brother, my sister, and you'll be blessed wherever you are. I hope and I pray that this will be a word of encouragement to you, for you to get up and get up from where you fall short and start doing the very things that you love to do for Christ. God be with you wherever you are. See you again.